Hello everyone, this is Razvan, the author of the Penmania blog. Today I would like to present you yet another fountain pen produced by Cross, 80 Cross from USA. This time it is a fountain pen which pertains to the premium line that Cross has. And I think it is one of the most well-known models. It is the Cross TOWNSEND. It has an interesting history behind the name. So TOWNSEND was, if I understood correctly, one of the sons of Richard Cross, the founder of the Cross Writing Instrument Company. And yeah, that's the reason this model was named after him. And also I understood that this model, particular model, was also a favorite of several American presidents, like Obama, etc., in order to, you know, to write documents and stuff like that. To sign documents, actually. So, let's get to the review itself. The pen comes in a big box, protected by a cardboard sleeve. We have here the name of the pen and also the name of the model and the color. It is the quartz blue color, which you're gonna see in a moment. It is a beautiful color. Again, I like the branding of the Cross company, very nice, including this, you know, the lion face done in the black part of the box. Simple box made out of solid cardboard. We have a presentation about Cross pens, the warranty, a protective pad, the fountain pen itself, and as usual, two Cross proprietary cartridges. The pen doesn't come with a converter, so from my perspective that would be the only downside for this fountain pen. The upside, it's the beautiful design, the beautiful color, and of course the texture of the material. I think you'll be able to see in the camera. So we have a vintage inspired design. Again, if I understood correctly, it's the Art Deco school from the 1930s. The fountain pen is made out of metal. We have brass and also steel used. The metal trimmings, so this part of the cap, the clip, the main ring of the cap, and this part of the barrel are rhodium plated. And the brass itself has a very interesting wave pattern engraved in the material. And then of course it is lacquered with a beautiful blue lacquered, as you can see. Very nice. So, a vintage inspired design, a classical design. Very nice. It is a long pen. So, the total length of the pen is 147 millimeters, and without the cap, we have 131 millimeters. So, let's see the cap. A long cap, kind of a jewel in here, very nice. And then we have the steel clip, rhodium plated. We have the name of the manufacturer in here, Cross. And also on the back of the cap here, hopefully you'll be able to see. The clip itself, it's usable without any type of issues. And we have a double ring at the end of the cap. The body, it's simple, and it is reducing at the end here. We have a small ridge, plastic ridge. It's a plastic circle, it's like that. And then the end of the barrel, which is again rhodium plated metal with rhodium plating. This is a push-off cap type of fountain pen. So you remove the cap like that. It has a smooth operation, as you can hear. We have an ergonomic section. As you can see, it is we have black acrylic here, black plastic acrylic. But if we unscrew the body, we can see again metal. So we have a brass metal with an acrylic exterior, which is fine. This means that this pen will be a solid pen and will withstand the test of time. I've inserted a cross converter, as you can see. Again, the fountain pen doesn't come with a converter. That's the way Cross is doing things. So the section has a cone type shape and has this lip designed to prevent, you know, the fingers of the user not to reach the nib. It's very comfortable to hold. You can hold it in several places without any type of issues. Very nice. The diameter, it's an estimate of 8.5 millimeters here to around almost 10 here. So very usable. We have a beautiful, I would say, number 5 nib. Maybe I'm mistaken, but it is a gold nib, 18 karat, with you know, a dual tone finish. We have, as you can see, silver and gold, and again a very nice design. The same lines from the Art Deco current that I was talking about. We have a plastic feed, which is also nicely done and fits well with the overall design of the pen, as you can see. The nib is a medium and it writes like a dream. So it's very, very nice, very well polished and done from this perspective. The cap can be posted on the body of the pen quite securely. And this is because of this particular ring that I was talking about. This will gonna reach the end of the inner cap. And there is a noise that states that the cap is securely. The cap adds to the overall weight of the fountain pen. You feel the weight here, but you can still write. Most likely for long writing sessions, I would advise you not to use the cap. So for quick notes or signing document or stuff like that, yes, you can use the cap on. But for longer writing sessions, I would say pass. Do not put the cap on the barrel. Do not post the cap. Again, very nice design. This texture, the brass texture is... it's a wave pattern, by the way, because I didn't mention that. So we have a wave pattern engraved in the brass metal of the barrel. Very nice. The cap itself, so I don't forget, as you can see, has an internal cap made out of plastic, which also serves as a protection against ink starvation, and it does the job, I can tell you, without any issues. Okay. So Very nice fountain pen. I think totally worth it is totally worth the price, around at least in Romania $270, so 270 USD, especially for what is offering. Again, the only weak point is the fact that we don't have a converter included by the producer. I want to show you a comparison in terms of size with other fountain pens. This is the Cross ATX. As you can see, it's longer. The Townsend is longer than the ATX, and this is a Pinaider Avatar. They are quite similar in size, although the girth of the Avatar is much larger than the Townsend. Okay, that's pretty much it. My conclusion is that I like this fountain pen. It has several colors available. Also, it has a version with a steel nib, which is cheaper than the version with the gold nib, but I think the gold nib version, it is totally worth it. So, depending on your on your objective, you can get the type of finish and color that you really like. So I hope this will be useful for you. Thank you for your time, for watching this video. And as usual, the writing sample will be available in a separate video. Thank you, and we keep in touch for the next review. Goodbye.